In Congress, what happens next in Congress, and the market reaction today. I'm joined by three guests. Here in Washington, Lawrence Yun, the chief economist for the National Association of Realtors. In New York, Peter Schiff, who heads up Euro-Pacific Capital. And in L.A., Chris Thornburg of Beacon Economics. Gentlemen, thanks to all of you for being here this evening. And Lawrence Yun, you're here with me in Washington. Let me start with you today. The House vote today, your organization, the association, favored this bailout package. How big a defeat is this? How worried are you about what happens next?
Well, we are worried because many of the lending activity, not only for mortgages, but for small businesses which create jobs, they will begin to dry up. So this was really a hit on the U.S. economy. I mean, I consider this not as a bailout vote, but an investment in American economy, because American government could have bought this mortgage security at a discounted value. So when the housing market recovers, that could have been a very good return for the U.S. taxpayers.
Peter Schiff, I hear you chuckling already. I know you're opposed to this plan. You've argued recession to solve our economic problems. Well,
I'm just laughing about the housing market recovery. I mean, we've got a long way to drop with or without this plan. I mean, part of the problem is housing prices got much too high. They're still too high, and they're going a lot lower. And, you know, people shouldn't be borrowing money to overpay for houses. And, no, this is a bad bill. I'm glad it failed. But, you know, we don't have any idea how much the market would have gone down today if they passed this bill. You know, remember, we were down 200 points right off the open. You know, we have a serious problem with our economy. And the only thing these government bailouts are going to do is make the problem worse. We need to let the market function. We need to rein in all this excess borrowing and spending. And that's what the market is doing. The reason there's no credit is because we've blown all the money. We borrowed all this money and we spent it on consumption. We can't pay the money back. So it's creating a lot of problems, but we have to let the market work. The government has already done enough damage in blowing up the bubble. They need to let it deflate.
Chris Thornburg, how about your take on this? Is the best thing for the government to do is simply get out of the way and let the market function here?
Oh, I'll try to go right down the middle here. And I think it's pretty clear that a lot of banks are holding a lot of assets that simply aren't good. Most of these banks are insolvent. If these banks start to fail one after another, clearly could cause a widespread panic and bring down the entire system. And that's not a good thing. We certainly don't want that. However, on the other hand, does this bill need to be in place? We already have the Fed as a lender of last resort to inject liquidity into the market when things start drying up. I don't know why they decided to go from being a lender of last resort to a buyer of last resort. Why that choice was made is beyond me, and frankly, I agree. I think it was a bad bill.
Lawrence Yun, you want to address that? Why become a buyer of last resort when you could just be a lender?
Well, the lender of last resort, I mean, certainly that could be inflationary. So what the federal government is doing in this plan is to borrow at 4% and basically make an investment on the U.S. housing market recovery. And
Borrow from who? We're broke. Borrow more from China? More from Japan?
Peter, hold on one second. Let me let Lawrence finish that thought.
If one borrows at 4%, and given that the mark-to-market accounting system, there's a great discounted value on the and the mortgage-backed securities. Once this value return, I mean, 4% borrowing rate, I mean, that's a very cheap borrowing rate to purchase
There's some people suggesting that the taxpayers could make money here.
No, that's not going to happen. Look, if these mortgages were really bargains, there's plenty of money around the world. There's all these sovereign wealth funds. They would be buying these things. The fact of the matter is they're worth a lot less, I think, than people think. The only way the government could keep all these lenders from going bankrupt would be to overpay for these mortgages. If they try to buy them at a price low enough to make a profit, they're going to bankrupt all the people they're trying to save. And you're saying we can borrow at 4%. Borrow from whom? We're broke. We don't have any money. We can't afford to borrow anymore.
The U.S. Treasury rate is at 4%. That's the market rate.
No, but who's lending to us? The Chinese, the Japanese, the Saudis.
Yeah, we can borrow at 4% or less.
But we're not going to be able to. We're going to have to print the money. People aren't going to lend us any money anymore. They're going to wake up. We can't pay back the money we've already borrowed.
That's the current market rate at 3.6%.
Let alone borrow anymore.
All right. Listen, we're going to hit a commercial break in just a second. Chris Thornburg, let me just ask you quickly the market reaction today. Your take, I've got about 20 seconds here for you. Is it going to continue tomorrow?
Yeah, I think so.
All right. Listen, we're going to hit this commercial break. We'll be back in just a second with our three guests. Continue our conversation in just a moment.